Hi everybody, it's Miss Barnacle again, and today we're going to be talking about adding and subtracting like fractions. And the first thing you need to know is, what are like fractions? Like fractions are rational numbers, which we talked about in a previous module. And that means that the denominators, if they're like fractions, the denominators in the fractions are the same, like 1/2 and 1/2. Those would have like denominators so that you can add or subtract them. So on the screen, you'll see this is just a little rhyme just to help you learn how to add and subtract fractions. Maybe it'll help you remember a little bit better. So it says, adding fractions easy as can be. All you need is an LCD, which in this section, all of the fractions are going to have like denominators, so you don't have to worry about that. And then you're going to write the bottom, collect the top, and then at that point, if you could reduce the fraction to lowest terms, you would take care of that, and then you stop. So what we're going to do is we're going to work a few of these on the board, and I'm going to show you how to do it using the rhyme. All right, so on the board we have 1/5 plus 2/5. They have like denominators, so all we have to do is adding fractions, which we're doing, easy as can be. All you need is an LCD. We have that. We write the bottom, collect the top. Collect the top means do 1 plus 2. Actually work that part out, that gives you 3. At this point, you reduce the fraction. 3 and 5 are both prime numbers. You cannot reduce that, so then I stop. Here's another one. 11/9 plus 10/9. We're adding again. All I need is an LCD, which is 9, and I have that. So I write the bottom, collect the top. When I collect the top this time, I get 21. And then I reduce my fraction. Now, in this case, I do have something in this fraction that I can reduce it by. Both of them have a 3 in common. And so from a previous module, we talked about if they both have a 3 in common, we would divide by 3. So if I divide the bottom by 3, I divide the top by 3, because what you do to one, you must do to the other, or it's not equal. So 21 divided by 3 is 7. 9 divided by 3 is 3. So your final answer is 7/3. Now you can leave it like that as an improper fraction, or if you really want to change it to a mixed number, you can, but you don't have to. All right, so over here we have subtracting. So subtracting fractions, easy as can be. All you need is an LCD, which we have, and it's 3. So we write the bottom, collect the top. 15 minus 6 would be 9. Reduce the fraction. I can reduce 9 and 3. 9 actually is divisible by 3, and 9 divided by 3 is 3. Then I stop. Now this last one gives you 3 fractions, and it's still the same process. You still have a common denominator of 12, so that's my like denominator. And then I just collect the top, meaning I do 15 minus 1. 15 minus 1 would be 14. And then I do 14 minus 4. 14 minus 4 is 10, so I have 10 over 12. And I notice that I can reduce both of these because they are even numbers. I can reduce them both by 2. So when I divide them both by 2, I get 5 over 6. And that is my reduced fraction for that part. So when you are adding and subtracting fractions, as long as they have a common denominator already, then you should be good to go. When you have the problem with unlike denominators, which we're going to do next.